Welcome everyone to the Flute Center of New York Salon series. I think this might be our seventh or eighth season. This first week of 2023. We're glad you're all here. We're really excited tonight to have Robert Langevin, our principal flute, and our beloved New York Philharmonic here, along with Linda Mark, accompany him. And then we have a masterclass afterwards with three people that will be playing for you. So without further ado, I want to also mention that this event is being sponsored in partnership with Brandon Flutes in Boston. And we have a number of flutes in the back for anyone to play afterwards if you'd like. So thank you, Brandon, and we welcome Robert and Linda.
Thank you. Thank you. I want to say a few words about the next piece. You may not be familiar with this composer. Her name is Mélanie Bonis, but when she wrote music, she lived in the middle of 19th century until early 20th century. What's interesting about her is that she studied at the Paris Conservatory composition. She was in the same class as Gabriel Pierny and Debussy. So she was in good company. After she left the Conservatoire, she got married and had some children. So for maybe 10, 15 years, she didn't write any music. But then once her children were grown up, she started writing music. And she's written a fair amount. As a matter of fact, yesterday I heard on the radio one of her orchestral pieces that I thought was very nice. So she's starting to be better known. I mean, you have to remember that in the 19th century, it was not deemed a proper profession for a woman to be either a doctor or a lawyer or a composer. I mean, nowadays, we have a lot of women composers, but I think there's a lot to discover from early the 19th and maybe even early 20th century. So this sonata she wrote in 1904 and is in four movements.
Thank you. Thank you.
next piece is by a contemporary composer who was born in 1970, Guillaume Connesson, and he's written a fair amount of music. And what's interesting about him, he had a training as a choral conductor, and he of course studied composition. But he says that he's had many influences, and I think like a lot of composers today, among others, he's been influenced by film composers. So he says, I wrote it down because the list is too long, I would never remember that. He was influenced by François Couperin, Richard Wagner, Richard Strauss, and Debussy, Ravel, Stravinsky, Messiaen, Dutilleux, but also Steve Reich, John Adams, and the movie composers Bernard Herrmann and John Williams. But my favorite one is the funk style of James Brown. Thank you. one more short piece for you. I don't think I need to introduce this one. You all know it.
It's like we find it. It was here. He seems to have lost it. Okay. Oh, here
it's not, it's not as good.
No, it's on the piano. Who took it?
It's not in the other room. Do you want
to? I guess, yeah. Let's have a look. Ah, Recital. That's what happened. Has that ever happened to any? Oh, I got it.
I am from Serbia. I am senior year in Miami Art Charter School for 4 months. And yeah, I've been in contact with professor like 1 month, and yeah, now I'm here. I want to continue my education here. And that's pretty much it.
Thank you.
So we feel good.
very good. So, you know, I will do the same thing in all this passage. Let's do maybe this one. Right, so all these lyrical passages, you really sing them, but then the everything is scherzando in piano. Let's do with the piano. Linda, can you do maybe just a few bars before?
Mm-hmm. I'll do actually 4 bars.
4 bars? Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, see, even in piano, I mean, sometimes one thing that in piano you don't need to articulate, but you should articulate the same way as if you were playing forte, but you just play the piano dynamics. So if you play forte, you do the same kind, but in piano. So we hear the claritator. Otherwise, it's not clear. The beginning was very good. Let's do the same thing again, please. So there should be a little bit of separation. And you do it with the and the tongue at the same time. So it's not entirely legato. If you wanted legato, you would not put those dots. So a little bit of the it can have, you know, you can take some time, you know, it doesn't need to be always in the same tempo, but and of course the F natural is unexpected because we're in E minor. So you want to show, you know, the audience that listen here, there's an unusual note coming up. So it should be different from the rest. Let's do the beginning again. Just time, just to prepare that. Can we do from the on the top bar? Do you have bar numbers?
Yes.
11. So, where's a good place? Maybe from here. That's bar 15. After the dump. Go ahead. Obviously is the variation of the beginning, so you can always, on those notes, you can play slightly longer, and the other notes that are not as important can be a little bit quicker. Let's do right from there. Maybe just at the end. You don't want to give it away too soon. One more time. In tempo, and you just at the very end.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try one more time.
Yeah.
I would do it rhythmically as written. No, there's 16 notes. Do just this bar directly, 28. Now, see, it comes too soon. Play it once, strictly in tempo, just so you have the rhythm in your mind.
Oh, yeah. I'm playing the same.
But that was better. The same place again before. Thank you. Yeah, so you see at the end, it of course it can be free, but the phrase is so whatever you do, we should feel the grouping that you're going to have. Whatever you do, you're slowing down, but always going to that. Let's do from bar 33. As far as dynamics at the end. So you have three different levels.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it probably,
okay.
Yeah. So what would you think dynamic wise to do here and then here?
I actually going here a little diminuendo, decrescendo, and then starting from mezzo forte piano.
Try it, because you have three different levels. Try maybe. So I think as you go down, maybe it's more natural to play a little softer rather than louder. Because see, this could be the end here, and this is just. See if I do from bar 35 on the second beat. It could end here, and it is just a. Maybe ending softer is more natural than ending louder. It's just, I mean, you really can do what you want, but it's just a suggestion. Let's do from bar 33. Softer also. It doesn't have to be as much edge in it. But maybe. So it just fades away naturally. Let's do one last time. Let's do directly from bar 35.
Natalie Trejo. I'm from Dallas, Texas. I'm currently studying at Manhattan School of Music, second year master's with Professor Linda Chessis.
Thank you.
This is a, Phil was showing me this. This is the Brennan number one. And I tried it. I'll try it. I think it sounds very good. It's not me, it's the instrument. You see what I mean? I think it's better a little later. And you know, Linda will wait for you. You don't have to be here. Let's try one more time. And then about the breathing, I mean, you have all these places where you can take quick breaths. You can take as many as you want to help you.
Okay.
So let's do the second time, that's bar 73. And of course here it would be Because you see, again, the skeleton, the melody, if you want, is. You know, so it should go forward. You want to do maybe, how about we do. Let's do this again. That's 163. Because it's slurred by two, it needs to be a little bit more articulated, so we hear. Yeah. And then I think also the fact of feeling it in one might help you for breathing, so you might not need to. See, you can take one here, you can take one here. I think it's doable if you plan it. Let's do the same place again. Sense to feel it. Usually, if you think larger values, so a 6/8, even in an andante, andante is not that, so thinking 2 rather than 6.
Okay.
Let's do right where you come in. You don't need the introduction. I think some of them are by the editor. It would be nice if you. Yeah, I mean, I think. Let me try this again. if you plan it, and when you breathe, you take a good breath. Because I mean, I think sometimes we get lazy in the way that we figure, oh, we can breathe. There's a rest. Some people, I hear sometimes they breathe every rest, and it's not. Necessary, I don't think. So let's try. Just you think of a long phrase and you take a good breath.
Mm-hmm.
sure you can do it. Let's try. And then, so I don't stop you later on. See, if you follow his marking, poco animato, go forward. I mean, I think, again, it makes sense musically, but it will also help with the breathing. One more time. So you go from here to here,
okay,
and then to here. So we'll erase this one as well. It will give you a longer line. So Linda, can we do a beat to 16?
Mm-hmm.
So you start. Softer than the beginning. because you were in the low register and you're playing with the piano, you have to, as you were doing, give more air. But when you get in this register, you can play it, you know. Let's do one more time, just before we start from here again. So, Linda, there will be the upbeat to bar 24. And the first one here, and then retain your toe even slower. So try to make it, you know, very organically. You know, so that it just fades away. Do the upbeat to bar 36. Yeah, so this way is a more natural. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much.
My name is Bianca Morris. I'm from Philadelphia. I just got my master's in the spring from Temple University, and I studied with Nina Stillman.
Thank you.
accent on the second eighth note. Well, there's an accent on the first one, but there's another one on the second. I think it can be more to show the syncopation. Same here. And for that, it's piano, but I think the accent. Even in piano, just to give it a little bit more shape. But let's start right where you come in the scherzo. Yeah. See, I don't hear a difference. I hear. One can exaggerate those words. Sometimes it's Scherzando, sometimes it's only accent, but just bring out the shape. One more time. So think of the B at the beginning as forte. I know it says forte here. Maybe play the A mezzo forte, but the B more. And then piano. Very good. Let's do it one more time, just so you have it in your head. It doesn't matter if you miss some notes. Yeah, I think we're thinking about the accents now, so don't worry about it.
Okay.
One more time. Rhythm. Think of the 16th later, because I was hearing almost triplets. Same thing happens in the first movement. So rather than more. Let's do right there on the minor muscle. First movement when you have all those on the late side, and even those 30 seconds a little bit later, it's really written ornamentation. Rhythm, the bomb, 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 which normally is done the second note is done a little bit later than rhythm. So it's you don't do pa 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 pa, but more like pa 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 pa, because it was a dance. So pa 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 pa. Same here. I mean, you this rhythm comes so many times in this movement. So let's do from your first entrance of the Poco Più Lento. You did not write it. See, I think. You know, the phrase goes until here. So I think, I mean, it's here, you know, you have freedom as you're doing very well on those, but just keep the long pulse, the four, fairly steady. Yeah, I think if he had wanted the team, he would have written it. Mm-hmm. And by the way, I was noticing the same thing here at the end. See here, you have a rhythm rallentando. So if you play it straight in tempo, it will sound ritmo. If you return, you know, slow down in addition, then we don't understand what's happening. So beginning is very good. Let's start. You think of going all the way to here. So from it'll be the upbeat. We don't have bar numbers here. It's the second the upbeat to our second bar. So let's see. That's what we right. Double dot in the 32nd, so which is the way I think one often plays a Siciliano rhythm. So more. Something like do you feel very free? I mean, it sounds sort of contradictory, because you want, if you play exactly what's written, but then you can, you know, play around with it. I mean, it doesn't have to be, but the basic rhythm should be there. Let's start one more time from the Andante Pastoral, please. Let's do. You see where it is, Linda? It's upbeat to the fourth bar of the Andante. Yes. Talking about, just so you understand. So we'll do from the last five bars, from where you had a right there. I think you'll probably find that you can get rid of these words.
Now that I'm not slowing it down.
Let's try it one last time. The same place.